eternal God is your dwelling place, and underneath are the everlasting arms. Cast your burden on the Lord, and God will sustain you. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Now we see in a mirror dimly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, then I shall understand fully, even as I have been fully understood. We brought nothing into the world, and we can take nothing out of it. The Lord gives, and the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Those who believe in me, though they die, yet shall they live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. Welcome to St. Andrew's Church. We are gathered here to remember Lindsay, to give thanks for her life, to ponder the mystery of death, and to commend her into God's everlasting care. We are also here to comfort one another in the hope that is ours through the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ. And so I welcome you into this house of prayer, that here this afternoon you might know God's peace. We'll follow quite closely this order of worship, and there's parts for all of you to play. I hope none of you are here merely as spectators, but rather as participants. You'll be joining in the words in bold. I won't be introducing folks, those who are giving tributes, those who are doing readings, so simply come to the lectern when the time comes. I think we need to acknowledge right at the outset what a difficult occasion this is. Who would have thought a month ago that we'd be gathered here, gathering anywhere, to remember this. The service itself has its own flow, and everybody afterwards is welcome to the reception in the parish hall. And if the food and the chance to talk with each other isn't incentive enough, I was sent yesterday an extraordinary film, 7 minutes long, tribute to Lindsay by one of her friends, and it's wonderfully done with the music and just an extraordinary array of photographs, and so we'll be playing that as well during the reception. We'll gather around and watch and listen. As we stand, let us pray. God of all consolation, you have not made us for darkness and death, but for life with you forever. As we remember before you this day our sister Lindsay, look on us with compassion. Give to our troubled hearts the light of hope, and kindle in us the gift of faith. In Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Please be seated.
The Lord is my shepherd. finally found a parking space, and we were walking on a rocky, almost ledge-like area towards Seal Beach. I had gone ahead of her, then eventually stopped for her to come up and catch up to me. And she looked out to the ocean to say, "It doesn't get any better than this." It makes me smile to remember her like that. My mom's a lot of things for a lot of people, a teacher to some, a friend to others. But to me, she was the person I confided in. She was the person who understood me and was my very best friend. Whenever I'd go to a new school, she'd say, "You're beautiful, strong, and talented. You're gonna rock it." And whenever I'd be crying over GJ or Andy, she would tell me some crazy story about them and soon we'd be laughing. Something amazing about her were her stories. She had dozens of them, all intricate and amazing. I may not understand things like about her, but like her obsession to 90s rock or why sandals just had to be worn in the winter. But I do know this. My mom was a person for everybody else. She was my biggest cheerleader. I believe she poured so much into other people and forgot to give back to herself. I know she's on a golden beach, keeping BT out of trouble with Andy beside her. And before I return to my seat, I just want to say we're all going through this together. We all may be going through different levels of pain, different stages of grief, but the loss is so same. So keep on praying.
I want to imagine the rejoicing in heaven when she was reunited with her mom and her beloved little chihuahua, Dooley. The tears I cry today will be happy tears to celebrate her beautiful memory. Lindsay was about joy, Lindsay was about laughter, and most of all, she was about love, and that's how I want to honor her. I was only privileged to know her for 14 years, but we packed a lifetime of friendship into that time. We were sisters, we were friends. We share our trivial moments, our joys, our disappointments, and our challenges. We talk through loss, grief, and moments too difficult to handle alone. She was there. She was always there in spirit, in person, or voice on the phone. She was my person, and I am so incredibly grateful that we always said, "I love you," at the end of every conversation. Literally, the last words we ever spoke to each other were, "I love you," and I'm so very thankful. I cannot speak of Lindsay without smiling. She was so beautiful, so smart, this lovely girl who was always dressed so nicely with her makeup done, so poised and charming, yet she was Murphy's Law in pink kitten heels. If it could go wrong, it did go wrong, and in true Lindsay fashion, she turned all those lemons into lemonade while laughing at her rotten luck. One of my favorite stories about Lindsay happened when she was about 8 months pregnant with Isabella. She had taken her Jeep to the GM dealership where my husband worked to get some maintenance done on it. At some point in the afternoon, my husband called me and said, "Some woman just drove her vehicle into the side of the service building, pushed in the wall, and knocked off the sink on the other side." After finding out that no one was hurt, I laughed and didn't really think much else of it until I got a call from Lindsay a short time later. "You aren't going to believe this," she said, "but I just drove my Jeep into the side of the building at the dealership." It was pouring down rain, and she was dressed in a cute little dress with darned little shoes, obviously inappropriately, and the rain had caused her foot to slip off the pedal while she was backing up, and she couldn't find the brake or see over her belly. Long story short, the dealership didn't find it nearly as amusing as we did, but Lindsay and I laughed about that story for the next 12 years. I was one of the first people she told when she found out she was pregnant. This was her miracle. The fulfillment of all of her dreams. She viewed being a mother as the greatest blessing a woman could be given. We would go to breakfast on Sunday mornings and go over names for her favorite rock star. I don't know if you're aware, Isabella. I know I just told you this. But for an uncomfortably long time, your name was going to be Bentley Rose. I think we were all glad when she switched gears on that one. I know I will spend the rest of my life missing her like crazy. I still have to stop myself from calling her on my way home, just to chat. I pray I never forget the sound of her voice saying, "Hey, beautiful," when she answered the phone. I know she is at peace. I know she was embraced by the light as she crossed into heaven. I know this, but I will forever wish that she was still here. I love you forever, Lindsay.
I met Lindsay the first day of fifth grade, and the first thing I noticed about her was her outfit. It was loud, it was crazy, it was fashion forward, which is everything she was. And for some reason, we just instantly connected, and we stayed friends since the fifth grade. We saw each other through heartbreak, breakups, loss, love, weddings, babies, the whole nine yards. And she was always my person, the person that I would call when life sucked, the person that I would call when something amazing happened, the person that I called when someone was doing something really stupid, and I was like, you're not gonna believe what this person just did. So for me, I too, like Danny, find myself reaching for my phone to text her, reaching for my phone to call her, because she truly was my person. I mean, I had two, and now I'm down to one, but I'm still thankful for her. But it's really hard, and the one thing that I hope everybody just looks for in this situation is the blessing that is Isabella, and that we're so blessed to have her continue with us and be with us. And just my hope is to let Lindsay's legacy live on through me guiding her daughter into adulthood and just giving her the best possible life I can, and that I'm so blessed that she chose me to be her guardian, and I would not have it any other way. So I thank you all for coming today and just celebrating the wonderful, kind, loving, inspirational person that Lindsay was, because even as quirky and crazy as she could be, she always looked on the bright side and she always had love for everyone.
Through a hard time many years ago, and in true Lindsay fashion, wasn't taking any advice. Certainly wasn't listening to it, even if she was hearing it. So I figured I like to write, and it was a way to get my thoughts out to her uninterrupted, without her saying how nice she liked to say. So I think this was particularly written after she had a breakup and feeling not good enough and down about herself. Not that she would tell me that, this was just something that I surmised from knowing her. So contextually, this is something that I had to go to make her feel better, to get her to listen to that interrupting me. It's called On the Rise. You think this is the end. Your one and only chance to get things right, don't you, my friend? You think it's all over now. The only footsteps you hear are under your feet, and that's too quiet somehow. Feels like it's always raining. Doesn't much matter, you would have stayed in anyway. It's just another hard day. Get up, move on over to the other side, take a look outside. You can stand by yourself, but you are not alone. Think it all ends like this, some cruel karmic destiny that leaves you with nothing, just some voices you miss. Can't see anything else but where you've been, bound by your determination to not go there again. There's a light that shines from deep inside you. Sometimes it takes the darkness so you can see it too. Open your eyes. You're strong, you're wiser. You've fallen before, you'll fall again. But I know you
Tell me, what does it look like in heaven? Is it peaceful? Is it free like they say? Does the sun shine bright forever? Have your fears and your pain gone away? 'Cause here on earth it feels like everything good is missing since you left. And here on earth everything's different. There's an emptiness. Things differ.
Set your troubled hearts at rest. Trust in God always. Trust also in me. There are many dwelling places in my Father's house. If it were not so, I should have told you, for I am going there to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I shall come again and receive you to myself, so that where I am, you may be also. And my way there is known to you. Thomas said, Lord, we do not know where you are going, so how can we know the way? Jesus replied, I am the way, I am the truth, and I am the life. Everyone who comes to the Father comes by me. Peace is my parting gift to you, my own peace, such as the world cannot give. Set your troubled hearts at rest and banish your fears. Here ends the reading. What extraordinary tributes we just heard. I want to agree with Danielle that this wants to be about joy. It's about celebrating her life, but right at the outset, we have to acknowledge the very real feelings of loss, of pain, and of sadness. And there's nothing in our faith that asks us to deny that. There is the pain of parting. And I know it was hard for George when he did that reading to ask that, add that last bit, a time to dance, a time to mourn, a time to dance. Well, this isn't a time to dance. Although, again, those tributes from Isabella teaching us something about grief and how we're all at different stages. And believe me, as dreadful as you might feel now, there will come a time. You know, for many of you, the loss of Lindsay just leaves a gaping and very painful hole in yourselves. And that hole may never be filled, but over time it will become less jagged and less painful. And there will come a day when you'll want to dance and sing. As we heard in the song we just heard, dancing in heaven is a metaphor as well. And I didn't know Lindsay well, but I knew her well enough to know that when you're ready to dance, when you're ready to smile and laugh again, she would be only too delighted. So in the days and weeks ahead, please, as we heard from our daughter, everybody grieves differently. And if you're ready to laugh and enjoy life again, no one would be happier about that than Lindsay. At the same time, we respect those who grieve differently. Some will want to talk about it incessantly. Others, that's the last thing they want to do. Others will want to get straight back into their routine. Others won't. And we have to acknowledge that pain of sadness. We're here to mourn her death, but we are also, as was made clear, here to give thanks for her life. And I think we want to just acknowledge those, the truth in all those tributes. I appreciate the way you let their words just lead into the silence, but why don't we show our appreciation now for those four extraordinary tributes. Oh, goodness. So much more to be said, right? I mean, Adam, yes, she's on the rise. Lindsay herself knew difficult times. We were here 2 years ago, mourning the death and celebrating the life of her fiancé, who himself died very suddenly. Lindsay knew what it was to grieve. She also had a strong faith. And again, yes, I don't know which one of you said it now, but we're not alone. And I think that she knew throughout her life and found some comfort and solace in God's Spirit with her. I also know that she so appreciated the friendship and the forgiveness that she had in her relationship with Jesus. Lindsay knew what it was like to grieve. Each of you will have your own memories of Lindsay. We heard in our tributes what it You may remember, if you go way back, Lindsay, on the stage. You may recall her in the classroom. Perhaps you remember her just at home, enjoying life's simple pleasures with her daughter. I suspect many of you will remember her on the beach. You just heard that wonderful memory of her on the Pacific coast. But she loved beaches, and it's not something I knew until I saw that video that was sent to me yesterday. But she had a thing for hats and sunglasses, right? How, whatever memories you have, we treasure these memories and we thank God for them. Because through these memories, Lindsay is with us still. God, of course, remembers us even when we die. God will not forget Lindsay any more than we will. We say goodbye to her today in the sure and certain hope that she is now safely in God's care. God's love for us is utterly unshakable. Even death is powerless to separate us from the love of God. Lindsay was not perfect. None of us is. But God, in God's mercy, forgives us all. So as we grieve for Lindsay, please remember that while she is gone from us, she is forever safe in God's keeping. May she rest in peace. Amen. And just prompted, really, by Isabella's memory, I just want to share this one piece written a long time ago by someone in England. What is dying? I am standing on the seashore. A ship sails to the morning breeze and starts for the ocean. She is an object of beauty, and I stand watching her till at last she fades on the horizon, and someone at my side says, she is gone. Gone where? Gone from my sight, that is all. She is just as large in the masts, hull, and spars as she was when I saw her, and just as able to bear her load of living freight to its destination. The diminished size and total loss of sight is in me, not in her. And just at the moment when someone at my side says, she is gone, there are others who are watching her coming, and other voices take up a glad shout. There she comes. And that is dying. And I invite, as you are able, stand as we just keep a minute of silence and we just remember what Lindsay meant to us. Blossom like a flower, and then we wither. We slip away like a shadow, and do not stay. In the midst of life, we are in death. And our prayers begin with the short. after me. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And now, as Jesus taught his followers, we say together, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
God of love, Lord of life, your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, wept at the grave of his friend Lazarus and comforted Mary and Martha in their distress. In our loss, O God, we seek your presence. In our uncertainty, your love. Draw near to us who mourn for Lindsay and comfort us in our sorrow. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Gracious God, you have made us in your image to reflect your truth and life. We thank you for Lindsay, the years we shared with her, the good we saw in her, the love we received from her. Now give us grace to leave Lindsay in your care. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
God of all consolation, deal graciously with Isabella in her grief. Comfort all of Lindsay's friends in their loss and sorrow. Be for them, O Lord, a sure hope and a strong refuge, and lift them from the depths of grief into the peace and light of your presence. Let faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. Lord, in your mercy. O God of mercy and forgiveness, grant that death may be for Lindsay a gateway into everlasting life. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Carry her safely home into the blessed rest of eternal peace, and to the glorious company of the saints in light, where you live and reign, one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. And we sing hymn number 671. That'll be in the larger of the books in front of you, the hymnal 1982. Hymn number 671. And we sing stanzas 1 through 4, the four stanzas provides lovely amazing grace in number 671.
Thank you.
and Roberts to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. Give rest, O Christ, to your servant with your saints.
Where sorrow and pain are no more, neither sighing but life everlasting.
You only are immortal, the creator and maker of humankind, and we are mortal, formed of the earth, and to earth shall we return. For so did you ordain when you created me, saying, you are dust, and to dust you shall return. All of us go down to the dust, yet even at the grave we make our song, Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. Lindsay, go forth from this world in the love of God the Father who created you, in the mercy of Jesus Christ who redeemed you, in the power of the Holy Spirit who sustains you. God, our Creator and Redeemer, gather Lindsay to yourself. Enfold her with your love, uphold her with your strength, embrace her with the arms of your mercy, and keep her ever close through the grace of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And now, having done all we can for Lindsay, we remain standing as we pause to pray for ourselves. Lord God, you brought us to birth, and in your arms we die. Keep us mindful that life is short and the hour of death unknown. Let your Spirit guide our days on earth in the ways of holiness and justice, that we may serve you sure in faith, strong in hope, perfected in love. And when our earthly journey is ended, lead us with Lindsay into your heavenly dwelling place where you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And our service concludes with God's blessing upon you. May Christ, the Good Shepherd, give to you and to all those whom you love his comfort and his peace, his light and his joy in this world and the next. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you always.
Amen.